Sunbird, this is Nightstar. Come in, over.
Sunbird here, go ahead.
We have found your prize.
Are you sure? Does it match the signature?
Yes, much to our surprise. I thought this thing was vaporware, but hey, it was your money. So we checked what feels like half the known universe.
Yes.
But where is it?
Would you believe in the station?
You mean someone already has it?
For now.
You have a large budget, Ghost. Can I trust that you'll take care of these matters?
Already in hand. It's certainly costly, though. I had to spend real money to dig up the name involved, and then even more covering our tracks, once I found out who it was.
We taking a risk?
Always a risk, Fallon. That's our business. Now, this geezer's a heavy hitter, no doubt, but fortunate for us, he doesn't actually have possession of the item. He just supplied it.
So, who has got it?
In a couple of hours, if all goes to plan, we will.
Until then, well, no one's special.
Name yet?
No.
But we can't keep calling it the Maelstrom.
I know.
I mean, it's embarrassing on the paperwork.
Aye.
And you keep having to say, I'm Captain John Rourke of this here ship, and then read out the hull number.
I'm working on it, okay?
You know, you can always call it Clear.
No, I can't.
Okay, I'm just saying, it's an option.
No, it isn't. It's not the same ship. It's not the same ship. Anyway, Sol, shouldn't you have been engineering?
There's nothing to do. It all works, all the time.
You sound almost disappointed.
Well, it's certainly a lot quieter here now. Testing station give us a load of work after what we did for them. The ship's insured, we're making money, and for once we're not spending it on repairs.
Well, there's a butt in there somewhere.
How about, but I haven't fired my new guns yet.
Oh, good grief, Charlie. I suppose it's too much to ask that one of us stays on station while we dock.
Why bother? It's dull around here. You know it and I know it. Safe job shifting stuff around a couple of jumps tops and no one goes near us because of our Titan killing rep.
I consider that to be a good thing. You'd rather we were getting holes knocked in us than spending all our money fixing the ship again.
I remember sometimes we knocked holes in other people's holes. That was fun. Ah, speaking of fun.
Tell him we're out.
John, I have a well-paid job for you.
We have heard that before.
What?
Nothing. Carry on.
I require part of your old ship back.
Really?
Yes, it is mine. I installed it. I need it back, and I'm willing to pay.
All right, keep your tie on. We can get it now if you're desperate.
Yes, that would be excellent. Hand it over in Teskinen at these coordinates at this time. I'll have a ship pick it up.
This gear's working great, Ghost. They're buying it.
Good. One fruity power supply, hand-delivered by gullible morons to a place with no station or gate guns within half a light year. How's our man at the station, Drank?
He's waiting for them to dock as we speak.
Spot on.
Excellent. I'll see you there.
Smith sound a bit odd.
Yeah, probably bored, like us.
We need all four stealth bombers to make it quick. Let them know they all get to play.
Sorry, lads. Nothing exciting is going to happen today.
Subject, John Rourke. Recent history, captain of Tempest-class Minmatar battleship Clear Skies. This ship was destroyed in the Tarquin incident. It was self-destructed by Captain Rourke in order to destroy an Avatar-class Titan set on collision course with Tarquin Station. Current status, residing in Tarquin system. Captain of Maelstrom-class Minmatar battleship, unnamed. Threat level, moderate. Known affiliate, Solomon Sol Burke. Engineer, served 23 years in Kaldari Navy. Threat level, low. Known affiliate, Charles Charlie Fodder. Gunnery. History, unknown. Threat level, high. Known affiliate, first name unknown, last name Smith, presumed alias. Possible Kaldari command operative. Supplier of power source designated FAL 01 to John Rourke. Threat level, extreme. Known affiliate, Sascha Culhane. Agent of Smith. Threat level, high.
Suppose we better undock then.
Early for once.
That's what comes from having a working ship.
Don't say that. Clear skies used to get us where we wanted.
And a lot of places we didn't.
Mostly that was JR.
May as well let Smith know we're here.
Mr. Rourke.
For once, you contact me. What could possibly warrant this occasion?
The fact that we're here early, for once.
And where would here be?
The rendezvous point in Tarquin. I've got the power generator you wanted.
What power generator?
The one off Clear Skies. You want it back? You only asked 2 minutes ago.
That still exists.
Yes.
That and all the other stuff you installed that somehow survived. We salvaged it. Why are we even discussing this?
I'm starting to get a bad feeling about this.
The equipment I gave you still exists.
Yes, and you want some of it back, don't you?
I want nothing of the kind, Mr. Rourke. That should all have been destroyed. It was imperative. Part of the deal. Do you realise exactly what...
Lads, maybe we should head back to the station, sort this out. We're in the arse end of nowhere, after all.
You fail to realise the magnitude of this situation. Stay there, I'm on my way.
What the hell was that all about?
I don't know, but can we please discuss this back in the station? Only I'm starting to get the heebie-jeebies, sitting out here all on our lonesome, when clearly something's up.
Will you relax? There's no one for a million miles in any direction. Who are they?
Well, it's not Smith.
Charles, one big fat target on a starboard bag.
Port.
Yeah, like I know. Stick a couple into them. Let them know we're not interested.
They're powering up the guns.
Well then, Trank. Time for the magic box.
Command override received.
What the hell?
The signal bus has just gone down. Seals have gone. Binders are offline.
Tracking's out.
Engines warp the lot. I've got nothing.
Offline. Tracking offline.
That ship can't do that. What the hell's going on?
Bombers, decloak and take on the bitch. Don't damage the cargo hold.
There's something else out. Bombs!
You're joking!
Do I look like I'm joking?
Hit the pod right now! Right
what
now! We're not stopping those with everything off! Strap in!
I was expecting to find you in a somewhat larger ship.
Nah, the fuel economy was crippling us. We downsized.
This is not a time for flippancy.
Well, maybe it's a time for straight talking then. Like, who exactly are this latest bunch of jokers you've dragged along in your wake, Smith?
I have not dragged anything anywhere. This mess is entirely your own creation.
Having been stuck in this system for the last year doing soft jobs, I find that highly doubtful. Even we can't upset anyone under those circumstances.
But you did store highly classified items in a Tatty station warehouse, and now you wonder why undesirable elements have come after them.
You didn't mention highly classified when you supplied them.
Correct, Mr. Rourke. they were classified.
What could be so special about a couple of ship modules?
Maybe they're stolen.
Maybe they're gold-plated.
Radioactive.
Radioactive and gold-plated.
And stolen.
Maybe they're Jovian. Actually, that's not as stupid as it sounds.
Oh, well...
It'd explain a lot, like how quickly all that gear fit together and just worked.
That's really not the issue.
And why I didn't recognise any of it.
Wait, wait, Jovians, are you serious? I mean, they're a myth, right? Genetically modified freaks, light years ahead of us, hidden away in some distant region, that sort of thing. Come on, it's the stuff you scare kids with.
I've heard a few things in my time about them, and this all fits.
Aren't they supposed to be, like, scary powerful?
Yeah, they are. Sol's right, this does all fit. Why have you mixed us up with them, Smith?
Yeah, don't make me put you in the airlock.
Very well. I am a Jovian agent.
I thought you worked for Caldari State.
Mr. Rourke, I have never mentioned who I actually work for. I'm sure now you understand why.
You don't look Jovian.
Of course not. Consider me a giver of gifts. For example, one race invents the jump drive, making capital ships a reality. Quite the advantage, I'm sure you'd agree. And suddenly, all the races make similar breakthroughs. I hear the Minmatar achieved theirs at a research station in the system of Heck.
Oh, did they?
Why interfere like this?
I have a simple brief. No one race can be allowed to gain an advantage sufficient enough to fight the other three and actually win.
Well, I don't know why you're fuming over this power plant, then. I've done half your job for you. Just hand over the blueprints to everyone else.
Half my job? That power plant is decades ahead of anything currently in use. You have released one of the most dangerous artifacts I know of into the hands of a complete unknown. I now have a staggering amount of damage control to perform. I expect a great personal risk when it isn't a tedious grind. I can't fathom the depths of ineptitude required to hand such an artifact over to the first person you met.
They looked and sounded like you. They certainly had a stuck-up attitude, right?
Perhaps a year of soft jobs in this system has significantly reduced your faculties as ship's captain.
Hey, they're sailing close to the solar wind, Smith.
Name me a recent situation where you didn't rely on the help of a friend to extract you, or perhaps the sacrifice of one.
You and I better go our separate ways. I see you again. You'll be the one needing friends.
I intend to. I have a busy time ahead rectifying your mistakes. See yourselves out when we dock.
Well, we've looked at this overpowered toaster and can't make sense of it, so it must be cutting edge, right?
Yes, and yet should work with the artifact.
Yeah, what is that thing?
An interesting question. We found it on an asteroid we were mining at the edge of known space. Ancient, but seemingly intact.
It took us a year to work out how to power it up.
Old and alien, huh? Must be worth a bit. What's it do?
Originally, we have no idea.
Oh, marvelous. So we can fire it up, but we lost the instruction manual.
What it used to do is not important. When powered up in the current state, this artifact seems to emit interspatial frequencies, equivalent to that of a fully functioning...
Excuse me?
Well, it will turn off stargates, if you give it enough power.
How the hell does it turn off gates?
Well, I was just explaining.
Shut
that.
Up, you. Why do you got such a buzz for turning off a gate?
Oh, not just a gate. All the gates in a system. All of them. Which means we can take our planet back. Get our home back. And no one will be able to take it away again. With their damn lies and their laws. And helping us with that is our next job for you.
Lucky me.
Lucky us. All this from a chance archaeological find.
Huh. I'm not a fan of archaeology. Things should stay buried.
Well, in your line of work, Ghost, I'm not surprised that that's your attitude.
Nice of Smith to drop us off in the middle of precisely nowhere. Good job you did there. You didn't upset me or anything.
You heard what he said.
Well, with the insurance money, we can get a cruiser.
Now, you know what? You know what? Forget it.
What?
Because the worst part of it is, he was right. All I do is blunder through life and bring death on my friends. I nearly got us all killed today. Again. I'm done.
Don't be daft.
No, I'm done, Sol. I should have given this up the last time. Seems I only learn when it's too late.
Where in the world did you go? Without a crew, without a word. What on earth did I do wrong? You won't believe how much I hurt. I can't believe the mess we're in. My sense of humor rare and firm gets away with murder every day. Can't you hear me? Won't you make it go away?
What do you want?
Haven't seen you for a month, and that's the greeting I get.
Shove it, Sol, I'm busy.
Busy finding the bottom of a bottle. As an engineer, I can assure you that it'll be in the same place as the last 12.
If you're just here to give me grief, I can get
that. Out of it, Sunshine. I've had enough of this. Come for a walk. Clear your head.
Yeah, that'll fix everything.
You found him, then?
Yeah, it wasn't hard. Just look for the nearest ratty red sofa.
What are you talking about? My sofa's in storage.
Oh, well, your sense of humour, it seems.
Right, yeah, lowest point I'm at in a long time, you want a joke.
It's how we work. You've forgotten that. You start thinking too seriously about what we get up to and it's going to end badly. Trust me on this. Me and Sol didn't exactly skip off into the sunset, you know.
Now there's a thought.
Isn't it just?
So what did you do then?
Ah, I'm glad you asked me that. I quite heroically moped around the salvage yard.
And?
While I was there, I couldn't resist looking at our classified Jovian tech. It's fed as some sort of filaments for all the salvage from clear skies. I guess that's how it worked so well, and while those bits survived the explosion.
So he comes and gets me saying, bring a welder?
Yeah, because when you connect the Jovian tech up to all the other salvage, the filaments sort of do all the hard work. Things just spring into life.
Things? What sort of things?
Well, there was I with all this Mimitar ship salvage around me. Some construction robots sat idle and nothing better to do.
You've rebuilt her. Oh my God, Sol, she's beautiful.
Welcome back, John.
Don't break it this time.
You've got the best of two Tempest hulls, everything from clear skies that wasn't destroyed, and parts of Mausum that got salvaged. It works, thanks to all the Jovian tech, but it shouldn't really. It's about four different ships.
No, it isn't.
It's far from finished, but it flies. We've got all the new control gear off the Maelstrom and a couple of other things besides.
Such as?
Well, with our track record, I made sure we fitted a damage control unit like most modern ships. Now hull breaches get sealed over a force field rather than us having to poke rocks in the hull like cavemen.
Nice one. Anything else?
I can tell you what we don't have, a micro warp drive, not after what happened the last time.
Yeah, the last time. I'll never be able to repay you for all this, Sol. Not just the ship, but everything.
I'm your friend, John. It's what friends do. Ah, I've got another surprise.
About time you showed up.
Oh my God, I don't believe it.
Hello.
My sofa.
Oh.
Oh, hi, Sascha. You even put my sofa on. Sol, you're amazing. Have I ever told you that?
Once, maybe twice. Only when you're drunk, though.
John, I need to talk to you.
I'll go see Charlie. You kids play nice now.
So what brings you here, then?
It's about Tarquin.
Oh, well, this'll be short, then.
We tracked down the power supply.
If you're about to ask for any sort of help whatsoever, that bridge is long burnt.
Put what happened behind you. Lives are at risk.
Of course they are. Usually ours.
There's a bigger problem as well.
Go on.
Smith and I dropped scan probes in about 100 systems looking for that power supply. We found plenty of junk. Wrecks, cans, wormholes, but we finally got a hit. Here in the Masoya system.
And I'm guessing it wasn't as simple as going there and asking for it back.
No, because when we jumped into the system, we found a capital ship fleet covering the gate. There were wrecks or ships all around, and the local comm was filled with pod beacons, distress calls, and a station broadcasting a siege alert.
It would appear we are late, Sascha.
Who are they?
We can only assume they are the ones with the power supply, and something even larger is charging up.
It seems to be coming from that Proteus cruiser.
I've just picked up a signal jammer. Oh, and three interceptors heading our way.
Time to leave then, Miss Culhane, and report our findings.
Tarquin!
It appears I won't be joining you on the other side.
Wait!
I'll come back!
No, Sascha, there are too many and there is no time to waste.
You must jump through and contact Admiral Eisen. Go now and tell him what...
I left him.
I'm sorry, Sascha. I know how much he means to you.
Tarquin gave me chances no one else would. My life would have been a lot different and probably a lot shorter without him.
So, what did this Admiral Eisen do?
He responded, but not quickly enough. The Sinosaur jam was already up and running. No capital ships could jump in.
Leaving conventional ships against capitals? Nasty.
John, there won't be normal ships going in either. Just after I jumped back out, the gate connection went offline.
Offline?
It went dead. No uplink, no matter stream, just off.
I've never heard of a gate turning off before, never.
Both the Masoya gates went off.
The system's cut off?
Yes, and it's a main route from Ethereum Reach to Metropolis. Traffic now has to go the long way round or risk pirate space up north. But the bigger problem is if this effect can be duplicated, whole systems can be held to ransom or simply dropped off the map. Our way of life will be over.
I can see where this is going, and we're just one ship, Sasha.
Tarquin was captured, not shot at. I need your help to get into Masoya and get him back.
I really don't...
If you're worried about payment or...
No, it's not that, for once. Look, I can't see this being anything but dangerous, and I've only just got the ship back. Heart and soul of my crew are in it. And without them, and without clear skies, I don't know where I'd be right now. And the first thing you want me to do is to risk it all, again? I don't know if I can do that. I'm starting to feel my mortality, Sascha. We've beaten the odds a lot, but we aren't going to win them all.
Smith was my only contact to any resources. I'm on my own. You're all I have.
I'm going to have to think about this and talk to the guys.
Please hurry. I'm asking you as a friend.
I didn't know we were friends.
Well, consider yourself told.
Yeah, I always like that about you. Hey, Heifer. Yeah, I know. I only ever show up when I need something. Well, this time, it's just advice. So, dilemma. I didn't do too well after, you know, that stuff between us. We lost the maelstrom. I know. It was my fault. I got complacent, and it took some pretty harsh words to hammer that home. I nearly lost everything. But Sol and Charlie rebuilt Clear Skies and brought me back, and I owe them so much for that. And now I have to decide if I risk it all again to help Sascha. I wonder if that's fair on us. But we're all she's got, and I can hardly turn my back on her after all that's been done for me, can I? So, I guess we go. Decision made. Thanks, Haf. You know, you never did talk much, did you?
Captain Rourke, you are cleared for undock.
Copy that, station, thank you.
No problem. That a new ship, John?
I have no idea.
Must be Minmatar then. Have a good flight. Station out.
The wingy bits are square.
It was a choice between no heat sinks and square heat sinks.
Preferred the old ones.
Well, if you've got some lying about, feel free to bolt them on.
Yeah, I'm all out. So, does any of it work?
All the important stuff does, but I've got a mountain of bug fixing to do.
Anything I can help with?
The doors could do with some attention.
Ow!
So, I found some of your favourites.
You got 1400s on it. Oh, yeah. New interface too. And a probe launcher. What do we need a probe launcher for?
Launching probes?
And what the hell is this? A YF-12? That's a bit old school, isn't it?
They were already on one of the hulls I salvaged, seeing as I paid for them, I thought, well, I might as well leave them fitted.
Yeah, but a YF-12? These things are dangerous.
Well, that's rather the point, isn't it? You're gunnery, not sociology.
Sol, can you pop over the cargo bay, please?
What, may I ask, is this?
You know, when you take something apart and put it back together again, there's always a few bits left over.
All sorted, Falcon. The gates are off, the Sinojammer is up. Masoya is all yours. Welcome home to the planet of whatever.
Haven. And the local population?
Just a bunch of miners. One look at your dreadnought fleet made them crap their pants. They'll give us no more trouble.
Good. Good. Well, you certainly know your business.
I certainly do. I also know I've now got about 6 months of tedium. There'll be a heavy presence of the law on the other sides of those gates for now, but that's not sustainable, so once they run out of budget, we can cycle that thing and let me and my men out while no one's looking.
Yeah, and everybody else who wants to leave as well.
No, you can do that on your own time, my man. I'm first out the door when the gates come back online.
I know. I understand. The local population is my responsibility.
And what about our nosy guest?
Well, he's an old man in a suit.
He can't cause any trouble here.
Don't worry about him. It's quite harmless.
So, you'll help Sascha?
Of course I will. It's not me you got to worry about, though.
I know. Sol rebuilt this ship. How can I ask him?
Bang, bang. It's coming. Follow my lead.
Your lead?
What do you mean, no? I can't believe you won't help.
Won't I? No, I won't. The help.
Won't help what?
He won't help Sascha.
Help him with what?
Picking up Smith.
Well, it's dangerous. Paint's not even dry on the ship.
Doesn't want to get his new ship damaged by helping poor old Sash.
Hang on, she asked for your help?
Well, yeah.
And you told her no?
Yes.
What, without him discussing it?
Well, I didn't think that...
After all the help you got recently?
Exactly my point.
Well, that's just... I don't know what to say, John. That's really poor.
I'm sorry, guys. I guess I was being selfish.
I guess you were.
So I'll tell Sascha we'll help after all, then.
Absolutely. Shame on you, John.
She'll appreciate that. What with the massive enemy capital fleet and the lockdown system we've got to get into. Nice one, Sol.
Thanks. Wait, what?
So yes, we all decided to help.
Thanks, guys.
So, what's the plan?
Plan? Well, the power plant's in a system of Masoya, which is now cut off. Question is, how do we get into a system with no working gates?
Easy. Carriers and dreadnoughts can jump in using a sino.
A Sinojammer went up before the gates went offline. They aren't that stupid.
Yeah, I suppose there's an old acceleration gate leading there.
Unfortunately not.
Well, the only other way I know of then is through a wormhole.
Whoa, I'm not sure you even want to consider that.
When we were out scanning for the power signature, our probes picked up other things as well, including... I think... There, an active wormhole in Masoya. Can we get in through that?
No, we can't.
Why not?
Look, wormholes lead to wormhole space, right? Some chunk of space that is otherwise completely separate to us. Thank you, Charles. So, to get to Masoya, filling up monstrosity would mean entering W space in exactly the right place to find it.
I thought all the holes were kind of clumped together.
Yeah, that's true, but there's still a lot of separate holes. Finding enough accessible hole that leads to the same clump would take weeks. And of course, there's the sleepers to worry about.
Well, I've got the probe results of all the systems we scanned.
Ah, bring up the ones wormholes in.
There, 17 of them.
Can we work out where they lead to?
You can see the stars and nebula of the destinations through them.
So if we see the same stars and the same nebula...
It'd be in the same place. There. The hole in Oimo leads to the same place.
So we go there, hop through two wormholes...
It's still not
and...
that easy. The hole has to be stable enough to carry all the ships we need, and we actually have to find an exit hole once we're in there.
We've got a probe launcher, remember? Something about it launching probes.
You're not helping. And the sleepers...
It looks like the Oimo hole is stable enough to fit about two ships through. Then it'll fold up. That'll do.
Wait, two ships?
We can pick up my interceptor on the way.
Am I hearing you right? Two ships against a capital fleet? Charlie, why have you conned me into this time, you fuck?
What did he mean, fundamentally flawed individual?
No idea, I'm sure. We're about halfway to Oymo. Just stopping off to get your ship, Sash. Got through the defence fleet yet?
Yes, finally.
Connecting you to Admiral Lyson now, Miss Culhane.
Miss Culhane, no new developments to report at Masoya, I'm sorry to say.
I have one.
We think we can get in there using wormholes.
Risky proposition, ma'am. Are you sure?
Of course you're sure. We'll try and light you a signal on the other side.
And you are, sir?
Charlie Fodder, the good ship Clear Skies.
Charlie Fodder. Charles Fodder, right? It is, isn't it? From the presidential
gardener list.
Some time ago, yeah. Now happily do my own thing, thanks.
So it would seem. Well, you're in good hands there, ma'am. Mr. Fodderite, if you can gain access to the Masoya system, it would benefit you to rendezvous with our unit already there. Let me transmit the details.
Thanks. Oh, it's Malozzi. How about that?
What, you've met before?
Yeah, briefly.
Well, Commander Malozzi was there on routine patrol when all this kicked off. He's nicely hidden in a safe spot. Apparently all long-range sensors and probes are banjaks from whatever caused the gates to stop working.
Nice to know. Right, we'd better be off.
Happy hunting. Oh, and Charles, we do have a rather more appropriate selection of battleships available, if you wish to transfer over.
I'd rather be on this ship with this crew than any heap in your fleet, matey. Trust in the rust.
But are susceptible to electromagnetic disruption, flying swarms, and apparently they can dissolve your hull in seconds. You see?
Nasty.
Are we talking about ex-presidential guards?
Very funny. No, this is the reason why wormhole space is considered dangerous.
Is this the sleepers you kept mentioning?
Yes. If you ever wondered why artificial intelligences are banned, this is it. Some idiot made one, it self-replicated, and started trashing the place, then legged it through wormholes when people tried to kill it off.
Are they called sleepers because they're slow and easily avoided?
Don't be daft.
Of course not.
No, they're called that because they were dormant, but we woke them up by poking around in their space and nicking stuff. Now, they're angry.
So, avoiding them would be a good idea?
Absolutely.
We're almost there.
Oh, bad news.
What?
The wormhole's still here. And it's stable.
But how is that bad news?
Well, it means we're actually going to go into it. Oh my word.
Just when you used to gate travel.
Yeah, that was rough. You okay, Sascha?
Fine, thank you. Found our way out yet?
That wormhole should be here. It should be easy enough to find. Get the probe launched and get scanning as soon as you can. Get yourselves moving. I thought you were a prof- shouldn't be affecting
good
you this
grief.
Much.
Got anything yet?
A headache. Okay, I've got the return at last. Getting us into warp now.
Whoa! What was that? Sascha!
I've hit something. My ship's damaged.
I've got pings appearing all over. This doesn't look good.
The wormhole's dead ahead and it's going our way.
Come on, come on!
Oh, crikey, it looks like sleeper drones.
Move it, JR! The hostile count's off the scan and they're closing in.
John, I can't get my engines online.
What?
Hitting that drone hurt more than I thought.
We'll turn
my guns still work, though.
What are you doing?
Getting their attention away from you so you've got a clear run to Masoya.
Wait, we're coming back.
You can't stop all these. There's too much at stake to worry about me. Just go.
Find Smith and get rid of that Jovian death trap before it's too late.
I can't leave you.
You've got a job to do, Captain.
You have to.
No! No, I will not leave another friend to die! Charlie, lock up the closest drones and get firing. So I'll start charging the YF-12.
Are you sure?
John, what?
Shut up and get ready to transfer over.
They pop easy enough. There's just too many.
Just cut us apart! Sascha, get in!
Come on, Sol!
Do you want me to go and cheat him and buy some batteries?
Sol, I can read their chassis numbers. Come on!
I'm on board!
Sol?
It's still charging!
Smartphone charge.
Done!
Got him! Get us through the wormhole before they regroup!
Welcome to you to Masoya.
Hell of a welcome.
What were you doing parked there?
My apologies, John. We were briefed by Kaldari Command as your exit point, but not, it appears, your exit speed. I was expecting two ships.
My ship's gone, but I'm still here thanks to John.
We're here to try and get Smith back, see if he's figured anything useful out. It appears he has, but we don't know...
You heard from him?
Yes, ma'am. He hacked into the station's systems and got a short message pulse out to us.
Let me replay it for you.
Should reach the Magellan, scheduled to be on patrol here at this time. I cannot transmit for long. Suffice to say, if you manage to board the station, I can guide you the rest of the way. I have information that will go a long way towards ending this.
That's all we received.
He's alive! We need to go to the station now!
Hold on. I don't care how much sensors are messed up by all this interference. When we roll up, they'll still see us through the window. I have a stealth bomber available, John. It should let you reach the station undetected, but after that, it's up to you. There isn't enough room on board for any Marines. Are any of you certified to fly cloak?
I am. Let's go.
Sol, stay on the ship and look after it. Charlie, start packing some guns.
Ooh, which ones am I allowed?
Sasha's angry. Bring everything.
Okay, once we dock, they're going to know we're here, so it's going to have to be quick.
You sure about this?
It's a backwater station with poor security. They haven't had time to upgrade anything, and no one's expecting us. Trust me, I know how they operate.
Yeah, seems like I've heard that before.
Ah, it seems you were correct, Mr. Rourke, that I would need friends the next time I saw you.
We haven't got long. Where are you?
Fortunately, very close.
Continue down your corridor and turn left. I have set off a fire alarm in a fuel storage area, which has nicely distracted my guardians.
Clear left.
Clear right.
Second door on your left.
The door's locked.
Yes, it would seem my captors thought of everything.
Well, this should help then.
What the hell are you doing with that?
He said bring everything.
Okay. Tarquin, you may want to find something to hide behind.
And what would you suggest?
Don't worry, this is a shape charge.
What sort of shape?
Spherical.
Most undignified.
You really have to work on your rescues.
I don't know if anyone can still hear, but there's an alarm going off. Let's go.
Ah, a stealth ship. That explains how you got in.
I'd worry more about how you get out.
Please, everyone, stay calm. There's no need for violence. Now, who are y'all?
I'm Captain John Rourke of the Clear Skies, and these are my friends.
One of which you kidnapped, along with the rest of Masoya. So, who are you, and what gives you the right to do this?
I'm Falcon Hausmann, and miss, that planet, Haven, is our home. Or rather, it was.
Was?
Haven is a hostile place. It was unclaimed until our ancestors settled there. We led a hard but good life until we discovered a major Zydrine deposit near our colony. Should have been the answer to all our problems when we sold the rights to Otherworld Mining, but it seems we signed the contract in haste.
And they ripped you off.
Well, the contract gave them rights to the site and the surrounding area for development. Surrounding area ended up meaning our entire colony, and we were firmly informed that our presence was no longer necessary. Oh, we attempted to fight the situation, of course, but everything was legal. So we used our payment to buy ships instead. We left in shame. Our ancestors' dreams destroyed.
If you could house your whole colony in ships, you could have easily moved to the station instead.
Oh, come now, John. We're colonists. Folks like us are hardly material for living in a station. You know that. So we became nomadic. Traveled the great wildlands. Dementia. Canid. We survived mostly on the proceeds of mining rare asteroids, but we also developed a talent for deep space archaeology, generating a significant income from selling the artifacts we found. However, the Empire Wars caused a mass exodus from the inner worlds. Suddenly, there was a great deal more fighting over all that territory. We were chased away, jump after jump, system after system, invariably ending up in a bitter fight with the inhabitants of the next place we stopped.
That's life in zero security space. If you're after simply out there, you're in the wrong universe, son.
Ooh, aren't you the hard case?
Come over here and say that.
You mess with me, you need a bigger gun than that, Sunshine.
God damn it, let me finish here. And we had two events that changed our course. One was finding the gate artifact on our last date, and the other was hiring Ghost here to find a power source.
Oh, so it was him. Did he tell you how he got hold of that power source?
Yes, he did. He purchased it via contract from an anonymous seller.
It was on my damn ship, and he dropped out of warp and cut us in half to steal it out of wreckage, leaving us there to die.
What? Wait a minute, is that true?
Does it matter at this point?
You can take that as a yes. It's half the reason I'm here.
I'm sure we could compensate here. I mean,
oh, you are way beyond that.
But I didn't know that.
And what else has Mr. Mercenary here said to you, I wonder, to get you this far down a dark path? Tempted by the smell of Zydrine crystals, were you?
You watch your mouth, Rourke.
I'm sorry, John. If circumstances were different...
What circumstances exactly? Getting taken for a ride doesn't justify warping in all guns blazing. Well, actually, sometimes it does. But not when you attack people who had nothing to do with it. That's crossing a line.
No, Otherworld Mining crossed the line. They took our planet.
Did they? The story you just told me says you sold it to them. Okay, you lost out. A lot. And that's a harsh life lesson for anyone to learn, no doubt about that. But you need to look in the mirror, because what Otherworld didn't do is come in here with a fleet, kill everyone who opposed them, and cut the system off from everyone else.
We didn't... It wasn't like that.
And they aren't in the dangerous position of having mercenaries call the shots either.
Okay, I've had enough of this. Drop the hardware, ladies.
Easy.
You're going somewhere out of my way.
You can still stop all this. Turn everything off. Jump out. There's got to be 100 systems.
We've come too far for that, Falcon. No turning back.
Yes. Yes, you're right. I'm sorry, John.
You carry on down this path. People are going to die on all sides.
No, I am sorry, John, but Guy is right. We've come too far. We've invested too much.
Don't do this.
Already done.
Medical systems engaged. Blood loss detected. Major lacerations detected. Insufficient medical supplies to repair damage. Seek medical attention. Warning.
The unit just says, get him to a hospital.
There is no polite, isn't the gate don't work.
Can we get him to Melosi?
No time. Do something. Fix him.
I don't know what to do.
Emergency. User dead imminent.
He's going.
Tarquin, the sample.
Sascha, I don't
John.
Think that
Use
this
the damn
is...
sample right now.
Oh, desperate times, I suppose.
He's stabilising! He's actually stabilising!
What the hell was that?
It's the same thing that holds clear skies together.
Gaffer tape?
Hardly, Mr. Fodder. Repair nanites, designed for advanced ship modules. When blended with Jovian technology, it can fix organic tissue. This is... was a test sample we had prepared.
Well, looks like it works!
The sample was key to humans. It seems your captain and your ship are now closer than ever.
Tell us what you know, Mr. Smith.
Their sinosaurial field jammer is located here, at a small undefended starbase around the moon. If we remove that from the equation, the Kaldari Defence Force can jump in and resolve matters decisively. Our one and only focus must be disabling that jammer.
Yeah, those things are heavily shielded. So what firepower have we got?
Well, there's that sodding great thing.
Aye. Somewhat lacking in guns, but plenty of fighter wings on board. What else?
Clear skies.
My stealth bomber.
And that's it. So, some fighters, 6 howitzers and a couple of really big bombs.
What's tactical say?
I've turned it off. It's depressing me. Any more bombers on board, Melosi?
Unfortunately not. We were here as a routine patrol, so standard loadout only.
Okay. Now, if the fighters attack the jammer, we can't use the bombs as well without risking friendly fire. And this ship is, for once, the most underpowered thing we have.
The hostile fleet is currently at the station, guarding the gate artifact quite closely. However, once we commence an attack on the jammer, Mr. Fodder, I would surmise that most of the fleet would be upon us within moments.
Yeah, and that'd be game over. Damn it, we haven't got enough firepower to take it out quick enough.
Distraction.
What?
John, what are you doing? You should be resting.
Forget it. Smith's things are working wonders. Okay. We need someone to distract their fleet while the rest of us give the jammer a kicking.
The only guaranteed way of engaging the fleet's full interest is to engage the fleet itself. And the Magellan is the only ship here capable of that.
You're massively outnumbered. You go there, chances are you aren't coming back.
I'm fully aware of that, Charles, but we are out of options.
With the bomber and our guns on the jammer, you'll only have to get their attention for a couple of minutes.
Seven hells is that?
Whatever it is, I can't get a scan of it.
Ah, I was concerned this would happen. I suspect my employers are less than impressed about the situation and have dropped in for a word.
Good. We can tell those Jovian freaks that... hello? Are you Jovians? Yeah, it was given to us by one of your agents. Hey, I didn't misuse... Yeah, but not a... I can't, you see. Would you shut up and let me speak? Okay, now, I haven't got all of your gear and... Yes, I know. I'm trying to get it back. In fact, can't you just go and get it yourselves? Oh, right. Simple as that, is it? Well, that's both me and you, mate. Yeah, and what's it wired up to, eh? What's shut down the gates? Who exactly left that drifting in space for 1,000 years? Because it wasn't us! Is this more of your messing about with our development, or are you just forgetful in your old age? I ain't finished! Now, your tech allowed me to stop some madman from killing everyone in a station a while back. Now, I lost my ship, and I lost a good friend doing that. And if you think that was a misuse of your technology, then you damn well better step in this room and tell me that to my face. Right. Now, I'm not giving you anything back. Not yet. Right now, I need this ship, and I need these people to try and fix what's gone wrong. You can see me after the smoke clears, if there's any of us left. Yeah, I understand.
What the hell was that?
A message from our sponsors. Apparently we're on a time limit. Let's go.
Commander Malozzi to all crew. You have been briefed on the situation we find ourselves in and why we are heading straight to the enemy fleet. Make no mistake, we are outnumbered and we are outgunned.
Our task, here and now, is to get the
full attention of every one of those guns and stand for as long as possible. I know you won't fail me. Malozzi out.
Someone tell me precisely where the hell that thing came from.
Don't know, mate. Jam is still up.
It must have been here all along. This damn interference!
They've launched fighters.
Get the dreadnoughts into siege mode and start hitting it. And launch our own damn fighters. Last time I checked, we had some.
Captain Rourke, we have engaged the fleet. Commence your attack run.
Gotcha. Let's go, guys.
Wounds 1-3, ready for launch.
Go ahead. Full capacitor power to the shields. Inject when ready.
There it is. Charlie, target.
Got sentry guns on our case.
Quite undefended, you said.
Perhaps I misread the plans.
Sascha, all the guns are firing on us. Do your thing and do it fast.
Sir, the shields have passed the warning threshold.
Engineering, spin up the drives and prepare for emergency warp. Captain Rourke, we're under heavy duress. What is your situation?
Met some unexpected resistance. Taken our guns off the jammer. We need more time.
How much more?
Charlie reckons about 2 minutes.
Very well. You'll get your 2 minutes, Captain. Make good use of them. Boost to engineering. Cancel warp and standby. I repeat, cancel warp and standby.
Breach on flight deck 3.
How many more birds still in the air?
14, sir.
Get deck 1 clear and launch everything we have left.
Sir, engineering is reporting the warp drives have gone offline.
Duly noted. Let's see if they can restore them.
The shields aren't going to hold much longer.
In fact, I'm very well aware of, Ensign.
But, sir, with no warp drive, how do we escape?
Our escape was always a luxury, miss. And circumstances now dictate is one we can no longer afford. I'm sorry. Today we find out what doing our duty really means.
It's almost dead, but I'm out of bombs!
Charlie, hit that jammer!
Shields are down, sir!
Over to you, John.
Commander Malozzi, we've destroyed the jammer. Commander Malozzi, come in. Please respond.
John, they're gone.
Damn it!
I'll contact the defence force when we're in warp.
You drop that sino and then you go, understand me? You get safe and you cloak up.
I'm sure I could.
That thing's made of tinfoil. I want you safe.
Okay, but only because I'm out of ammo, don't think you can order me around.
Yeah.
incoming communications from the Masoya system, sir.
On screen. Miss Culhane, tell me I have good news.
Sir, the jammer is down. I'm about to light a cyanofuel for you.
Now transmitting the tactical data Commander Malozzi recorded.
And what of the Magellan?
Lost, sir.
Thank you, Sascha. All ships, all ships.
Prep for jump with immediate combat readiness. We will be dropping into a hot situation. Engage targets of opportunity until ordered otherwise from Field Command Tactical.
Cloak up, Sascha. We're about to drop in.
Incoming warp signature, Ghost. Two ships, no, hang on. One ship.
Oh, come on. We just got rid of the last idiot. Are they lining up or something?
That's a lot of ships.
What have we gotten into this time?
Look, it's just an old battleship. Hold your fire and open comms.
No. Something isn't right here. Why send in one big boat for us to chew on and then roll up in that bag of nails? Oh, you're joking.
Surprise! No kill bonus for you.
Shooting you was pleasure, not business.
Rourke, now you need to stop this. Please, I don't want any more fighting here.
That's not your choice anymore.
Oh, no. Half a Tempest is threatening me. I'm deeply concerned. Wait a minute. Where the hell's my jamming field? Rourke, what have you done?
Sascha, it's time.
Time for what?
Jump!
It's hot drop o'clock!
God damn it!
Oh, no, this isn't right.
Thank you, Mr. Rourke.
We'll take it from here.
Glad to have you in system, sir.
It's not supposed to happen like this.
Okay, start locking up targets on my calls and focus fire. Trank, get your ass into a fighter and pot that Tempest. And you, don't you panic. Keep it together, man.
Launch fighters!
Charlie, hit the support ships. And Sol, scan out that progress. I want my power plant back.
They're falling apart. I love my guns.
Keep on hitting them.
Plenty of targets.
Shields are holding out fine. We appear to be on the winning side for once.
Changing mag!
Sir, fire control reports the Doomsday Beam is ready.
Thank you, Ensign. Tell them Saturn carrier on the way.
Sir, we've just lost a Ken Roberts.
The Protoss is the other side of this lot. We've got to go through.
If only we had a micro warp drive.
Shut it, Fodder. We've got afterburners they'll have to do.
I'm going to get you now, Rourke.
Picked up two fighters on a tail. They're too fast to hit.
We can tank them, just don't get hit by anything big. What did I just say?
Status.
Shields are barely holding now. We can't take any more hits.
Well, that may be a problem.
Get us out of here! Warp off!
Too late for that.
Don't accelerate towards them! What are you doing?
Trust me. I'm Captain... John... Rourke! Fast. Charlie, all guns front. Sorry, girl.
Ah, crap!
Dave, it's actually gone to use!
Now I remember why you're captain.
Two more of our ships have stopped responding, sir.
This wasn't supposed to happen.
Well, it has. Suck it up.
No, it's too much. Open a channel to them.
What are you doing?
I came here to give my people a safe home, but I've lost more of them in the last 5 minutes than in the last 2 years. No more. It's over.
Sir, Admiral Eisen responding.
Admiral, please, this has gone too far. We surrender unconditionally.
Glad to see you finally come to your senses.
Consider yourself under arrest. Power off. Unload all weaponry and lower your shields. Prepare for boarding parties.
Broadcast to the fleet, please. Everyone is to stand down. We surrender.
Except all directors from the Kaldari fleet.
And I'm so sorry that I let you all down.
You aren't wrong there.
Ghost, please.
Save it. I'm not interested. Thanks to you, what's left of my crew out there are going to serve time. My reputation isn't going to be worth a unit of Tritanium. And on top of that, I expect I'm not going to get paid. So, if you don't mind, get your backsides into the escape pods. I'm taking this ship, and that junk is now officially my retirement fund.
He's running for it.
Get on him. For once, we're the fastest thing around here.
Locked up and in firing range.
Hit him!
Shields down.
Hit him again!
His binders just went offline. I'm picking up atmospheric venting.
Finish it!
I'm out!
What?
No more shells. Sol!
Well, I wasn't expecting a full-scale war, was I?
Damn it, if he makes it to a gate, all this is for nothing. Pump everything we have into the thrusters.
I can boost it by about 20%.
No, I need double the power.
Double? Well, we can do it if I shut everything onto that bus, but it'll probably burn half of them out. What's this it made of?
I'm going to hot dog it.
Hot dog? Hot dog? You can't hot dog in a battleship. Oh, what am I saying? You're going to do it anyway, aren't you?
Have it!
You son of a...
He's coasting, so are we. We've blown navigation.
We've still got a shuttle on this thing, right?
Yeah, but what's that got?
I'm going over. Stop him once and for all.
Well, what about us, then?
I need you two here, covering me. Put in a resupply request to the fleet and get the guns and engines online again.
Take too long.
No way, that can't
wait. You, gunnery. You, engineering. Me, responsible for what happens on this ship. None of this would be going on if I hadn't let them jump us in the first place. And that happened because we got fat, complacent and slow. And that's my fault.
I'm not letting you walk away from us again, John. We near lost you last time.
You wonder what I do here other than stare out the windows? Well, it's this. Get my ship running again, because if I can't stop him, I need you capable of firing on that ship until there's nothing left. And besides, I've got unfinished business over there.
Hey! My ship may be a wreck, but I still know when someone docks. You amateur.
Oh, come on. I've had bits of my ship hit me harder than that.
Enough of this.
It's going to take over 10 minutes to get a supply of ammo over here. How are the engines?
Not fixable in the next 2 minutes. Hang on, I've got into his systems. Oh, no.
Why are you still doing this? When everyone else has given up. Your cause is over. It's finished.
Yeah, all I need is one shot.
Finished? Maybe for those chumps, but not for me.
One shot. Wait. Let me fire up Bob.
I'm a mercenary, my man. A gun for hire. I haven't got a cause. The only thing I care about when it comes to those losers back there is that I never got my goddamn money.
How about that?
Sabre armor piercing? Perfect. Get it to gunnery fast.
Now this, this is priceless. There's nothing like it on the market. I'm gonna take it as payment while your friends are all preoccupied cleaning up that mess.
That thing's more trouble than it's worth, I promise.
Oh, I don't intend on owning it for long.
For a shot like this, it's got to be done manually.
But we're drifting. I can't stabilise it.
Lucky for us, I'm a good shot then.
Good shot? Charles Fodder, ex-presidential guard, this has to be the best shot of your life.
Oh, and thanks for the shuttle. And I think I'll take your ship as well.
You might find that last part harder than you think.
Yes, you do appear to be remarkably resilient. It seems I should have shot you through the head the first time. Let's hear it for second chances, huh?
Best shot of my life.
John Rourke, captain of the clear skies and major pain in the ass. Any last words?
Yeah. Take your best shot.
Goodbye, Mr. Rourke.
Bridge detected. Emergency force fields deployed.
Yes!
John, are you okay? John?
Yeah. It's a little damp.
It's over. The power plant's secure.
Well, I think I can safely say, after the mother of all shakedowns, the ship appears to work okay. What's up with you? Gate's back online, ship's more or less intact, job done.
Yeah, that's the good news.
And the bad is?
Well, remember that little visit I had from the Jovians? It was about them getting their stuff back.
Isn't their stuff the only thing holding this ship together?
Yeah, I just got a message from them. They're not going to take Clear Skies apart, they're just taking the whole ship through that.
What? It took me months to put it together again.
I'm sorry, Sol, but there's no arguing with these guys. And face it, getting this tech out of the universe can only be a good thing. You guys understand that?
Suppose.
Yeah, I do. It's just after all the work and all she's been through with us.
Yeah, well, thing is, they want all their tech back.
Wait, you mean what's
yeah,
in...
Yeah, unfortunately their stuff's kind of holding me together as well.
They can't take that. You can't survive without that. They can't do this.
Sascha,
I won't let
Sascha,
them.
Sascha, they know, okay? That's why they gave me a choice.
Which is?
To go with them, through that.
What's the other side?
I don't know.
I can't believe you're accepting this. You're just going to go.
I'm sorry, Sascha. I wish I could stay. I wish I could stay with you.
Mr. Rourke, their patience wears thin.
This is so rushed. I'm sorry, guys, but you need to leave now. The shuttle's ready to take you to the station, and from there, well, I don't know.
So this is it.
It all had to end one day.
All things do, Mr. Rourke. All things do.
Well, certainly has been an experience flying with you, Captain Rourke.
And you, sir. And Solomon. Thanks for doing all the work.
Yeah, well, someone had to.
Fly safe, John.
Always. I still have my ship. And I still have my sofa. I love my sofa.
Any room on there for us?
What are you still doing here?
Oh, come on, we kind of you to have all the fun.
Universe of adventure out there and all that.
Besides, you could get into trouble dressing in the morning, never mind being an ambassador for the human race.
Yeah, you need us.
Yes. Yes, I do.
And you certainly need me. So, Captain John Rourke, part human, part Jovian, and now all mine. Any clouds on our horizon?
Nah.
Engines offline.
Sol?